The vegan diet is the only one shown to reverse heart disease. So,
right.
Or is yours?
I've heard also this in slightly different variations. Plant-based diet or a healthy plant-based diet is the only one shown to reverse heart disease. Different variations, but people are essentially referring to the same thing. And this stems from the Ornish lifestyle heart trial and the Esselstyn report. And basically, there's a number of caveats to these studies when you look at them that don't really allow us to say that, A, that there is a reversal of heart disease or a regression. In the cardiovascular literature, it's usually referred to as regression, but it's essentially the same idea, is that the plaque is getting meaningfully smaller. And the focus tends to be on clinically meaningful, so that it actually makes a difference clinically and in terms of risk. So there's a number of concerns with these studies as justification to make this claim. One is the design of the studies. So Esselstyn is not a trial per se, it's a case series. So he's basically reporting his observations and the outcomes of his patients that he advised that they should do this diet. There's no control group per se. There's a group that he used as sort of a control that's essentially the group of people that did not adhere to the diet, that did not want to or could not stick to his prescriptions. He's looking at them and saying, look, these people had a higher rate of heart attacks and strokes than the group who did stick with my diet. There's nothing wrong with him reporting those cases. It's great more doctors should do it. However, when we look at this type of evidence, we have to analyze it objectively. And there's a lot of confounders when something is structured this way, because someone who can't stick with the diet, who falls off the wagon or won't stick with the diet, is also less likely to follow other type of health advice, is also less likely to exercise, more likely to smoke. At first glance, the interpretation would be, okay, so people had these outcomes, they did better because they ate his diet. And that could be true. We're not saying that that's ruled out. However, because there are all these potential confounders, it could also have little or nothing to do potentially with the diet, right? These are all possibilities that we have to consider. Mm-hmm. These confounders are always potentially present. So what you do is, depending on the design of the experiment, you either adjust for them statistically. If it's a cohort study, you're going to assess all of those, who smokes and how much, exercise, BMI, education, socioeconomic status, all those things are going to be recorded. And then you're going to adjust statistically with multivariable analysis, and you're going to get a sense of whether the effect of the diet still survives. And here, because it's a case series, there's no such process. So the confounders are essentially unadjusted for. Mm. The other good way to address that is by doing a randomized trial. You take your ideally homogeneous pool of volunteers, you randomly assign them to the diet and the control group. And that is a more reassuring way of minimizing confounders. Mm-hmm. So those are some of the concerns with Esselstyn. Now, on that note, Ornish has the lifestyle heart trial has a more robust design because it is a randomized control trial. Caveats are pretty small number of participants, not the end of the world. Multi-pronged, so there were multiple interventions. It was a 4 or 5 intervention, so it was a diet, an exercise program, a relaxation meditation program, reducing or stopping smoking. They lost weight quite a bit compared to the baseline and to the control group. So again, we have a multitude of things. If we wanted to say that this program had a benefit in terms of the outcomes, I think that's fair to say. But to conclude that it's the diet specifically, mm-hmm. very difficult to sell that.
So there's just too many things considered as, or too many things used as an intervention for them to claim that the singular one out of the five was...
Right. It's a multi-pronged intervention. And again, that this is not to bash Ornish. This was the experimental design. So they set out. Mm-hmm. They didn't set out to prove specifically that the diet did it. They set out to get the result, to get the best odds of improving outcomes and stopping growth of plaque or even getting some reversal of plaque, right? Mm-hmm. So they threw everything they had at these people. This is very common. The misunderstandings and the disagreements are often not on the data, it's the interpretation of the data. So we should just be careful not to overstate it. The other thing that is sometimes forgotten is that the Ornish, the lifestyle heart trial, wasn't a vegan diet. It was a moderate vegetarian diet. So it has some dairy in there. Mm. sometimes people forget that and go as far as saying it's the vegan diet that has to be vegan. If it's not a vegan diet, you can't. That's not supported by the Ornish trial, right? Mm-hmm. So bottom line, it's possible that the diet is having that effect, but we just can't say based on the evidence. It's possible that 5 or 10 years from now, more results will nail that a vegan diet or a plant predominant diet is sufficient to get these results. So right now, I think we should be agnostic,
right,
with regards to the granularity, not the general idea of a plant rich diet.
But so to be clear, you're not making the claim that the diet didn't cause the heart disease reversal. You're just saying that we don't have enough reason to believe that it did, given.
Yeah, it's not. Exactly. Yeah. It's not convincing. It's not convincing. I'm not convinced that the diet alone did it. It's possible. It's certainly possible. We just don't have the evidence to say that. And certainly to say that it was a vegan diet that did it and that only a vegan diet could do it, that is really a stretch. A couple more things. Mm-hmm. The technique, without getting too into the weeds, the technique that was used, the imaging technique, is angiography. Basically, you're getting an image of the outline of the lumen of the artery and not a measurement or a visualization of the plaque per se. And so there's some uncertainty there as well. Angiography gives you sort of a surrogate and sort of a guesstimate of plaque, but it's not a reliable measurement of plaque. So if you see it's called the stenosis, right? The narrowing of the artery where the plaque presumably is. And you can see that widen a bit over time with the treatment. Mm-hmm. But there's more than one way that can happen. Yes, the plaque could be shrinking. The artery could be dilating. There's even technical reasons. The angle at which you're visualizing the artery could influence that as well. Mm-hmm. So there's just some uncertainty there with the technique. There are more recent techniques that are used now in statin trials and things like that that specifically look at the plaque and can measure the plaque more accurately. Mm-hmm. There is also some specific criteria in the literature that are thresholds for where it's considered clinically meaningful regression of plaque. And it's pretty hard to cross those. Even the statin trials, most of them don't reach that bar. These diet trials don't even get close to that bar of really compellingly showing a reduction in plaque that is clinically meaningful. Another thing that's interesting to note, when people say the vegan diet is the only one that has this effect, there have been other interventions. There's one actually that was published last year, this large trial called CordioPrev, and they used a Mediterranean diet, classical Mediterranean, right? Not what people are eating nowadays in the Mediterranean region,
right?
Not the McDonald's and everything, but what's normally referred to as the Mediterranean diet in the literature and the classical Mediterranean, with whole foods, lots of fruits and vegetables, some dairy, olive oil, low in red meat, low in processed foods, etc. This was a very large trial, 1,000 volunteers over 7 years, massive trial, and they used ultrasound in the carotid arteries in the neck. And there was a suggestion of a reduction in plaque size. I would not claim that the Mediterranean diet reversed the heart disease. I think that would be a bit of a stretch as well. But you see what I'm saying. If we're gonna claim that the suggestion of reduction of plaque in the Ornish trial proves reversal, we have to admit these things as well. We can't kind of gerrymander.
Let me see if I also understand this correctly. You said that the Ornish trial wasn't even on vegan diets. It was vegetarian?
Yeah. The lifestyle heart trial, I'm pretty sure it was a moderate vegetarian diet. So it was largely plant-based, plant predominant, and then it had some dairy in there.
Okay. So not only was it not even a vegan diet, but to use this trial is to also indirectly accept this Mediterranean trial, which also wasn't even a vegan diet, because they included some amounts of... Okay.
Yeah. Both diets are plant rich, plant predominant, maybe that's even fair to say. The Ornish diet almost certainly is getting more calories from plants than the Mediterranean diet. But otherwise, in terms of this suggestion of regression of plaque, I think they're about the same. Someone who's a, you know, a specialist in imaging might disagree, might think one technique is more compelling than the other.
Right.
To me, it's clear that one is super convincing and the other is not. Really important.
Sure.
A lot of this discussion on plaque size kind of misses the big picture, which is the actual outcomes, right? At the end of the day, and this is very common in nutrition debates and nutrition controversies and disagreements, is people harp on things that aren't necessarily the biggest question that we have to answer. So plaque progression and speed of plaque progression, that's absolutely relevant. But at the end of the day, what you care about is outcomes. The risk of having a heart attack, a stroke, revascularization, of dying of a coronary heart disease, that's the million-dollar question. And so both the Ornish trial and for example, this CardioPrev trial showed an improvement in symptoms, an improvement in outcomes for these plant-predominant diets. There's no reasonable doubt that healthy lifestyle, including diet rich in unprocessed plant foods, is a pillar of prevention and management of cardiovascular risk. There's no real doubt about that and the potential that these things have. It's just that extra stretch of saying that it has to be 100% vegan, otherwise you're killing yourself, and that only the vegan diet has shown this and not that. That's a little bit of an overstatement.